Hey everyone, and welcome to this video on how to create this web device animation with CSS only. Yep, you heard me, no JavaScript involved at all. All you need is a bit of HTML and some CSS, and you can create something as cool as this. It goes from mobile to tablet to desktop, and it's very reminiscent of the animation on the World Food Program UIKit. So if you have a look on the homepage of the storybook, intro page, it's got this animation on the right where if you click it, it just goes through all the devices, so tablet, mobile, etc. And I thought that was really cool and I really wanted to make something similar. So I'm going to show you how to make something like this very quickly. So let's jump right into it. So we have a totally blank canvas here, and the first thing we need to do is just add some HTML. Now the boilerplate for this is really simple. All we want is some really semantic HTML elements. We want the main, and then we want a section element nested within that. And then we want within the section element, a header element, an article, and a button. And that's it. And that's enough to get started. And then when it comes to CSS, we want to basically set our CSS preprocessors to SAS in CodePen. And then we can start writing. I'm actually going to change this view. So the first thing we want to do is we want to decide how long we want the animation for the device to be. So we'll set a SAS variable of 4 seconds for the animation. And then we want the colors here. So I'll put the British spelling for it. And let's put these colors down. So we want a background color. We want the colors for our windows. So this is within the device itself. And then we want a button color for the button itself. The next thing we want to do is make sure that we've got all our widths set here. I mean, it's an easy place to just come and tweak things if we need to in the future. We then need to. And that's it. I think that's the variable setup. And then we want to start writing the card. So we'll start writing the section component first. And we'll say it's position relative, because we want it to be able to contain some of our windows, as we'll have them as a position absolute. And we'll start setting the window width here. Height here as well, like the background color. So we want the animation to use the forward animation. We want to set our duration of 4 seconds here, and we want it to infinitely go on. And obviously we want to make sure that the overflow is set to hidden. Now within here we just want to say everything is all the child elements are going to be just position absolute. That's why we've got position relative here. Right, let's crack on with the header. So actually we don't need that, it's a semantic element. So we want to position this at the top. And we want to position in the top left hand corner, obviously. Let's go across. So let's add our height to the header as well. And we just want to add some border top as well. And we'll give that our window bar color. And then we're just giving it a very similar animation to above, but we're actually wanting it to be for our header. Brilliant, I think that's the header done. And you can see it's starting to take shape now. Let's deal with the article. Let's just add the positioning. We want it to be top 30 pixels. We want it to be somewhat in the middle, and we want to set our content width here as well. And we'll add a nice box shadow as well. We want to set our background color to window content, which is basically just going to be white. We just want to make sure that that's centered. And then we just add another similar animation to above, but this time for the article. And then for tablet mode, let's just add that in. We want the styling for that to be position absolute. Obviously, we want it to be from the top. We want it to be margin top as well. And we want it to have a 100% width because we want it to be within the container. Give it a height of about 100 pixels. And then we want the background color to be window content. We'll add some lovely box shadow as well. And because it's a pseudo element, just need to make sure that we add it as an empty content string, just so that it actually does appear. Cool. Right, so let's start tackling the buttons. So we want that to be position absolute as well. We want it to be sort of just about 10 from the right. And we want this to be positioned within the window itself. So we want to have our variable dictating the height to do that for us. Close that. We don't want any margin or padding really. We'll just set a width of 20 pixels. Set a height of 20 pixels as well. A border of 0. Border radius about 100%. And we'll add another lovely box shadow effect. And we're gonna add a background color for the button to our button color, which we've already set. And you can see that that's now showed up. Let's add a lovely button animation as well. So we're basically just doing the same thing we've been doing and just animating it forwards and just keeping it infinite and keeping it to the 4 seconds we've already set. And we're setting it to the button component. Cool. Now comes the fun part. We're going to dive right into the animations. So to start with, let's set the keyframe for the window. And we'll do that about 0%, 15%, and 19%. Those are kind of the timings we want to do it, and at that point. So we'll do it by setting the width, because obviously these are meant to represent like responsive devices. So we're just going to set the width and height. It's pretty easy to kind of gauge. This is a separate device. Cool, so we've got that set. And let's do 30% and 45%. So if you're wondering what these are, these nths, this is basically saying this is the second nth child. We want to set the width of that to window width. Just if anybody was wondering what that was. It's basically just a shorthand for that. Just add the last one there. Brilliant, so that's all set up now. That is the window sorted. Let's tackle the header. So very similar to the keyframes window, we want to set the 0%, 50%, 90% animations. So we want that to be 100% width, and we want the height to be set for the first one, just a header height, etc. And then we just do the same, going down for the second child. And then the third. Let's do the article now. So we've already set our variables before to basically deal with these sections. So content width, we've already set. If we go right to here, content width. So we know that these are the resolution or the device sizes that we want. We can basically just use that now for article as well. So we're using content width and content height. Let's do 30 to 45%. Cool. Right, so let's do the last one. So the third child. Brilliant. Let's do the button. Very similar to above, but we're actually using the button variables. So as you can see here, we've already got our button sizes here. We actually want to set the top animation as well, because we are going to have to change this button height depending on what device we're using. So should we get that correct? So let's do 30%, 45%. So we want it to be a little bit bigger than before. We want it to be right 10%, right 20 pixels. And header height 2 and 26 pixels and times it by 0.5. Cool. And then obviously we just need to set the width and the height to the button variables that we've already set above and we're using here. And we just want to go a bit more right in the last final animation. We just want to go to 25 pixels. And that's really the only difference there. So something seems to be up. There we go. We've made our section element, which is basically a semantic element into a class, which we didn't need to do. Brilliant, so there we go. Right, so we've got the article showing now, we've got the devices changing. We just need to make sure that we just style this a little bit. So we style the page itself. So I just want to add just a bit of styling to the page, add a obviously border box, just clean up that. Just clean up some of the margin and padding on the actual body itself. And then we'll just add some styling to the body in particular. So we'll say display flex, just justify content center. So we just make sure that we put the device in the center. We want it vertically in the center as well. And we'll set the background color to the background color that we set the variable. Once it loads, hopefully that should be sorted. Oh. Come on, there we go. And that's how you do it. So it's as simple as that. I'll leave a link to the CodePen in the description. But yeah, give it a go. It's a lot of fun. I really enjoyed making it. And having something like this and just being able to make something like this is a lot of fun, and it's crazy that it's CSS only. So give it a go, have some fun, and if you want to add it to your portfolio or add it to your website, go for it. If you found that useful, please do like and subscribe, and as always, I've been Harry and this has been Curious Byte.